Hey everyone, it's Monica with Scrapping for My Boys. So I'm here just to do a quick video, but knowing me, it probably will be like 5 to 7 minutes long, 10 minutes, who knows, I talk a lot. But just to give my thoughts on this glue that my girl Shantae, hey girl, she told me to try it out. She knows how much I love my art glitter glue. And she's like, girl, this glue is bomb. You have to try it. She's like, I bought this and I haven't reached for my art glitter glue since. I was like, oh dang. Because, you know, everybody loves the Dries clear glue. And if it made her put it down, then the glue's got to be good. So she told me about it. And like 2 days later, I went to the Dollar Tree to pick it up. I was like searching. I went down the craft aisle. I checked that aisle twice and I could not find it. I was getting mad. And then she's like, no, girl, it's there. Go find it. So I was expecting a bigger bottle. I didn't realize it was such a small bottle. So I'm looking for it like on a counter, on the base floor. It was hiding up on the pegboards. So I'm like going slow, really slow by the aisle, and I found it. It was like hiding. So they have two different types of glues. I believe she's tried the two different ones. I just went with this one first because I wanted to see how it was. So I tested it out today. I was working on my next die feature series project. It's a very quick, simple project, so I'll have that video up in a couple of days. So I was testing it out. Hold on a second. Let me close my craft room door because my kids are watching TV and it's loud. Okay, so I tried it out on that project, and I gotta say that I really like the glue. It is very, very comparable to the Dries Clear glue. This glue is pretty expensive. If you're looking at it retail, I looked, because the company that really promotes this is Heartfelt Creations. They sell it for $7.99 for the 2 ounce bottle on the site. I searched the internet, Amazon, eBay, you can find it anywhere from $6 to $6.99. Highest place I've seen has been Heartfelt at $7.99. So I didn't check Joann's. Joann's probably carries it, and you can probably buy it when it's on sale, but I'd say you're still looking at like $4 for the 2 ounce bottle. Plus you have to buy the fine tip separately, which on this one I did as well. It does fit. It is the tip for the art glitter glue. I have a couple of bottles because I love this glue. I even have the 8 ounce refill bottle. And the reason I have a couple of bottles, and what, I'll backtrack, but when I went to Dollar Tree, I bought 5 of these. I bought everything that they had. They had 5. The reason I got so many, and I have probably like 3 or 4 bottles of this, of the 2 ounce. And the reason I have so many, because it's small and I craft with my door open. So my kids are constantly coming in and out. I don't craft for long periods of time because my kids need something or my man needs something. So I stop and I walk away. Majority of the times I walk away with this in my hand, not even realizing that I'm holding it. And then I'll set it down somewhere and then I lose my mind because I can't find it. I mean, I've found this in the refrigerator. I've found it in, one time I was putting pans away in my oven. I put one of these with the pans. Well, it's like the cookie broiler sheet. I put that back in the oven when I was putting it away because I had taken them out. I put this in the oven. I put it in counters, pantries, the bathroom, you name it. I've left this bottle. That's why I have multiple, because if I leave one and I'm crafting at that time, it won't stop me because I'll literally stop what I'm doing and I'll tear the house up looking for this little bottle of glue. So I have multiples. So that's why I bought 5 in case I'm holding this and I walk away and I set it somewhere and I can't find it again. Okay. Back to it. So the project that I created, like I said, it's going to be for my next die feature series video, which I'll post in a couple of days. It works great. I would say that the open time on this is a little bit less than the Dries Clear glue, just fractionally. Granted, if you use a whole bunch of glue, gobs of glue, you're obviously going to have more because you have more wet, more of a wet medium to slide around. But if you're using average size glue, you got to work fairly quickly. This dries fairly quick as well, but this one is a tad quicker. So if you're looking for a very, very open time on your glue, don't use this one. But for just regular gluing, this is absolutely great. And I used this for all of the adhering that I did on this project that I'll be showing in a few days, except for the metal. I added a couple of metal pieces. I will always use glossy accents for my metal. But my bling, the die cuts, everything, I used this glue. I even used acetate on this project, and I used this glue, and it glued wonderfully. On the bling that I added to the project, because I add, of course, I always have to add bling, I added additional glue to make sure it oozed out when I pressed the bling down, because I wanted to see if it dried clear, and it does dry clear. Now, if you're gonna be using this on colored cardstock, definitely be more careful, because you can tell the glue. I dropped a die cut I was gluing down by accident in the wrong spot. I rubbed the glue off. I used my adhesive little eraser, and you can still see the mark of the glue. So I try to mask it off with my Spectrum NAR sparkle pen. But I would definitely say on white cardstock, you can't tell if it oozes out. Colored cardstock, you can definitely tell, but I would say that's just like any glue, except the zip dry glue. That is the best type of glue that you can use that won't leave a mark. I used that a lot when I used to do my 12 by 12 scrapbook layouts, because if you ever put too much, you dry it and you just rub it right off and it's like it wasn't even there. So I love that glue as well. It's just too expensive to use on regular day-to-day crafting, so I only use that glue when I'm scrapbooking, which I haven't scrapbooked in a very long time, and I'm planning to get back into it. But yeah, absolutely awesome. But like I said, the zip dry glue is like $8 for a 4-ounce bottle. So usually when I buy it, I use a coupon, a 50% off coupon at Michael's, because I'm not paying $8 for an adhesive. But yeah, like I said, these two glues are very, very comparable. The fine tip from the Art Glitter Glue fits on here to give you the finer point. Because the glue, it doesn't have a wide nozzle. I don't know if you can really see it, but it's not too bad. But if you're looking at very detailed work for die cutting, then you'd want to get the fine tip for the glue. And for this one, it comes sealed, so you have to go ahead and cut off the top in order to get the opening open in order to get the glue out. So this glue is 1.2 fluid ounces. Now, the packaging, well, the glue itself does not say if this is acid free. The packaging might say it, but I opened all of them and threw them away, and I looked in my craft room trash bin because it's all paper and stuff. So I looked through it, I was digging through to see if I could find it. It actually went into the bag that went outside to the trash earlier today. So I'm gonna have to search on the internet to see if it's acid free. I mean, but if the whole acid-free thing doesn't concern you, this is a perfect alternative for the Art Glitter Glue. It is a fraction of the cost. Yes, this one's only 1.2 fluid ounces, and this is 2. But even if you buy this with a 50% off coupon and you can get it for like $4, you still get 2 for the price of, not even the price of one, even half of the cost of this one. This is only $1. So I think for the price, it is very comparable to this one. Now, I love my adhesives, so I won't necessarily switch 100% to this one, because like I said, this has a slightly more open window time, and I vary. I jump from adhesive to adhesive. I love my ATG. I love my liquid glue, my Dries Clear. I love my glossy accents. I love score tape. I mean, you name it, I love it. I will use it. It just depends on what mood I'm in. But I will definitely continue to use this on more projects. That way I can continue to see what my opinion on it is. But for what I've used it for so far, it works absolutely great. For those of you that are on a bigger budget or go through a lot of adhesive, this cheaper option is definitely the route to go. For those of you that either don't have access to getting the Art Glitter Glue or are just looking for a glue that is much cheaper, head to your Dollar Tree and look for this. This is in the kids crafting section, and it's typically on pegboards. Shantae told me she found a 4-ounce bottle. I'm dying for a big bottle, so I'm gonna keep looking at different Dollar Trees. I'm even gonna search online to see if I can find it somewhere else. But I'm perfectly okay with this small bottle. I have small hands, so I'm actually okay with this size. As you can see, the size difference isn't that much as far as height wise. Well, yeah, it was a little bit. And to the side, you see it. So also, if you don't have much space, much smaller bottle. Anyways, that's it. I'd say head to your Dollar Tree, check it out. Let me know what you think. And again, Shantae, thanks for hipping me to this glue because I love it and I will continue to use it. And I will probably stock up on more bottles because knowing me, I will lose this one just like I lose this one all the time. And this is a good glue for when my kids are crafting. It's cheap. They can definitely use it because a lot of times my oldest son will come in here to make something for me or for something for the family. And mom, I'm going to grab your glue. I'm like, no. So they usually use like their school Elmer's glue. But keeping this in stock, my kids can definitely use it. I can use it. Again, the packaging does not say if it's acid free. So if that's important to you, search the internet, look for the company and see if it is. Usually if something's acid free, it'll mention it on the bottle. But again, like I said, this is a dollar. I don't think they're going to sit there and necessarily add it to the bottle. It's possible that the packaging it came in has it. But yeah, I would say it's probably acid free. But that's just a guess. Alrighty, I've rambled enough. I'm out of here. Again, Shantae, thanks. And I will catch you guys in another video. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.